softies and slabs. People simply haven't got enough of Zoom. But hold on a second and listen very carefully. It is emerged that Zoom has been inadvertently been routing many of your calls to servers located in China. And several vulnerabilities have been detected as well, raising major alarm. Zoom admits that many of its calls have been routed through data centers in China. There have been multiple instances of Zoom video meetings being hijacked by outsiders. Experts across the world have noted security vulnerabilities in Zoom's software architecture, leaving millions of corporate professionals vulnerable to sensitive data being stolen. In fact, India's very own computer emergency report team has warned about Zoom, even saying that video calls and corporate information could be stolen by hackers. If you're alarmed, give the mission much help. That's India's Defence Minister Rajnath Singh using the Zoom app to talk to India's Chief of Defence Staff with a recent spotlight on Zoom's track. It's likely the government will rethink using Zoom for calls. But we understand what you're thinking. Zoom is addictive and difficult to give up. With widespread adoption, it's convenient. It allows a large number of people to conference at once, and unlike WhatsApp, which only allows 4, and Google Duo, which can't take more than a dozen. But if you're feeling locked into Zoom and wondering about steps you can take, pay attention. For starters, always use private mode. And never publish your public meeting ID anywhere. Always use password for all meetings. Never share control with unknown participants. Use two-factor authentication where possible. And always, always, always report unauthorized entries. With remote workplaces likely to become a standard even beyond the corona crisis, the sooner the world gets a fix on its Zoom-like existence, the better and safer. Bureau Report, India Today.